said, you used totally wrong concept, totally wrong visualization technique, totally wrong language. And eventually, the national space, there was a lot of debate in the fourth national report on spatial planning of 1988. There was a lot of resistance from the Ministry of Spatial Planning to other ministries, especially the Ministry of Economic Affairs, because by discussing the economic structure of the Netherlands, the National Spatial Planning Agency was moving into the territory of the Ministry of Economic Affairs. Those things are also behind this, this kind of structures. And eventually the National Spatial Planning Agency had to give in. This IT ended up in the middle. I saved this image from the archives. And a kind of very complicated policy trajectory started, in which the four Randstad provinces, we are in one of them, in South Holland, and North Holland to the north, Flevoland to the north, east, and Utrecht to the east, and the four main cities, Amsterdam, Rotterdam, Hague, and Utrecht, they were asked to elaborate the idea that the Randstad is a kind of important international business environment, and how you could stimulate that from the perspective of spatial planning. And they were also asked to develop some ideas about to organize complementarities, to organize, for instance, business environments in such a way that certain companies would go to Amsterdam, and other companies to The Hague, other companies to Rotterdam. And this was asked far too much from the provinces and the four main cities, because the whole exercise ended more or less into nothing, into a document. There was a document, because this exercise always ends up in a document in the Netherlands, a nice book with a cover which you can store vertically on your shelf. As there's a little translation from a very nice French expression, you can store things vertically. But eventually, a map has been produced. This is still a map, because I think that every visual expression which is connected to a concrete area is a map. This is a map, a very symbolic picture of the very abstract picture of the Netherlands, of the Randstad, with four wings, so everybody is on board, and with a suggestion of improving the internal links within the Randstad through these thin red lines, and suggesting also the importance of paying attention to the area where cities and the green heart are mingled up with each other. So a very abstract image of ideas which were already there. So in terms of innovation, there's not very much new produced in this exercise. And planning, what's my time for? I think 1:30, isn't it? Sorry? 20 minutes, okay, then I can make that. National spatial planning returned, on Randstad planning returned to this idea of compact cities, but there was a broad pressure from the domains of urban design, from spatial planning, from geography, but also from politicians, especially in the parliament, and sometimes parliament has a very close relationship with certain people in academia. They were forcing national government to think again about core planning ideas. And there was a group of people, one in fact from here, Dirk Freeling, working together with other people, suggesting that one should reframe the Randstad, not using the term Randstad anymore, which is based on the idea you have a string of cities around the green heart, so it's based on an urban rural antagonism, but suggesting you should reframe the answer in a different way, much more pointing at strong interrelationship, but also pointing to what is very characteristic of this part of the world, is the relationship between urban system and the delta system. And the suggestion was that you should reformulate and completely turn the Randstad idea in another way by calling it the delta method. So this is one of the images that have been used in one of the, this is the, an image called, used in a booklet called the Delta Metropolis Declaration. It's half the image. I couldn't put the other half of the image, because otherwise I had to take this book apart, which I didn't want to do. And this is interesting because of its projection. When you want to stimulate people thinking in a different way about territory, space, spatial organization, one way you can do that is tilting the map. This, in the past, what we, the north is nowadays always at the top of the map. In the past, it hasn't been the case. The north has been everywhere on the map. And north is the west. There are also maps. Maps have been made about this idea of of the urban pattern in the western part, and it's very much linked to the water system by turning the map 180 degrees. What you have then is water is visualized. You don't have a map at hand, but you can image that if you turn this around another 90 degrees, water flows downwards and it pinpoints at the importance of water. So this is a nice, it doesn't show anything about the internal structure of the Randstad. It runs just image with this circle, but it has been useful in making people sensitive for the idea to reframe the Randstad. This suggestion that you should look at Randstad as an integrated urban area where there are all sorts of connections between its cities, it has been taken up in what eventually was the fifth report on spatial planning. It came out in 2000, if I remember correctly. And a major map is this map. In what is interesting about this map is in this report introduces the concept of an urban network. And in academia, there has been a long discussion of what is an urban network, what constitutes an urban network, how are the various parts of urban regions connected to each other, are there external parameters, is it possible even to define external parameters, and how are urban networks connected to other urban networks, but national spatial planners, and especially social democratic ministers, if I had power persons in office at those days, they were pretty certain what the urban networks were in the Netherlands and which cities belonged to them. So they defined, I have been counting them, there are 13 urban networks on this map divided in three classes and all 65 cities, and you possibly would know of even think that the Netherlands had 65 cities, but these urban networks are composed of 65 cities in total. That is the suggestion of this map. The government who produced this fifth report, it was, you have to be very careful about sticking labels to coalition government. You can say this was a center-left government. It was replaced by a center-right government, which had different ideas about spatial planning and the role of national spatial planning. And the planning agency, the ministry, and the minister itself. And so